So this king will take control of the entire world for 3.5 years, or 42 months, or 1260 days. The numerous scriptural references show that there is no doubt about the period of time being discussed here. The Antichrist's reign, however, will come to a rather abrupt end with the glorious return of Christ Jesus. The prophet Daniel ends his writings with a precise timeline to the end of the tribulation. From the abomination of desolation, or the defilement of the Jewish temple, until the end, there will be 1290 days. One may ask, why the difference between 1290 days referenced in Daniel and 1260 days talked about in the book of Revelation? The book of Daniel is from the Jewish perspective, but the Revelation is from the Gentile perspective. Most of the end times Jews get saved after the second coming and miss the rapture. They are truly left behind. Yet, most of the end times Gentile chosen participate in the glorious rapture. We escape the hour of testing, or the bowl judgments found within the last 30 days of the tribulation period. Romans 11:25-26 state, Israel has experienced a hardening in part until the full number of the Gentiles has come in. Zechariah 12:9-10 state, on that day I will set out to destroy all the nations that attack Jerusalem, and I will pour out on the house of David and the inhabitants of Jerusalem a spirit of grace and supplication. When Daniel discussed the 70-year Babylonian captivity, it was not exactly 70 years to the day that the Jews returned to Jerusalem, but it certainly was in the 70th year. Likewise, the tribulation, though 7 years long, is not exactly so. Tribulation has 42 months on the first half, with the beginning of the peace treaty to the abomination of desolation, and 43 months on the back half, or 1290 days, till the end of all of God's judgments on earth. So Antichrist's rule ends at the 42 months after the abomination. Therefore, the raptured saints experience exactly 7 years of the tribulation, but escape the last 30 days. So, Jesus dwells on Mount Zion after the second coming, and heaven is with him there, as well as all the raptured saints. After Jesus is established on Mount Zion, he and his raptured saints are attacked. This war occurs around day 21 after his return, and is known as the Battle of Armageddon. Many find this statement difficult to believe, that Jesus would be attacked after his return. Revelation 17:14, however, clearly says, they will make war against the Lamb, but the Lamb will overcome them, because he is the Lord of lords and the King of kings, and with him will be called his chosen and faithful followers. After the devastation of Armageddon, there will be one of the greatest revivals in the history of God's people. Joel 2:28-32 states, and afterward I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy, and your old men will dream dreams, your young men will see visions. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days. I will show wonders in the heavens and on earth, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. For on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there will be deliverance, as the Lord has said, among the survivors whom the Lord calls. The survivors mentioned here are those who remain alive until the end of the Great Tribulation. We must remember, after the flood, God promised never again to destroy all living creatures on the face of the earth ever again. In fact, the prophet Isaiah predicted destruction by fire with this next time around. He said in Isaiah 24:6, "Therefore earth's inhabitants are burnt up, and very few are left." So, what happens at the end of tribulation? There is a great ingathering period of 45 days where all the survivors come to Jerusalem. Isaiah 45:20 through 23 states, "Gather together and come. Assemble, you fugitives from the nations. Turn to me and be saved, all you ends of the earth, for I am God, and there is no other. Before me every knee will bow, by me every tongue will swear." There are multiple other references describing this great ingathering. It is during the great ingathering that construction of the millennial Jewish temple begins. The altar and foundation of the temple are laid before sacrifices and offerings are started, and the 1,000-year millennial kingdom reign then begins.